First of all, if you look at the aircraft that's on the mural, there are 22 aircraft there. And in the center part of it is the aircraft dealing with World War II. P-51 Mustangs in particular, they call them red tails, the ones that have the red tails on them. There are three of them. And what happens is when you look at those murals and you look at those Mustangs from the left part of the mural on the extreme left, and you watch them, they're flying toward each other. And as you move toward the right of that mural and go down to where the space panel is, you'll notice that the aircraft pivots and they fly in opposite directions of one another. So they move, it's an optical illusion. You know, that's one thing. The other thing that you may want to pick out is there's a spot on that mural where there's no paint. In other words, the canvas is naked. And it's a little spot, and it's actually on the larger part of the P-51 Mustangs, where the insignia is the star, and the star is the circle, and then it has two rectangles on each end. So if you look at those rectangles, or at least the white part of the rectangle, that's natural canvas, that's white canvas, no paint. The other thing that you may want to notice is that at the very first part of that mural, there are two figures. There's Eugene Jacques Bullard and there's Bessie Coleman. They're full figures. You know, they're about almost 6 feet tall on the mural. If you look at those two figures, especially if you look at the very first, which is Eugene Jacques Bullard, if you're a painter, if you want to learn how to do a detailed painting of a portrait, there's a lesson plan in those first two figures. So what you'll notice is that as you look at the paint, and especially the coat of Eugene Jacques Bullard, that's what's called the block-in technique, where when you're actually putting paint on, you're just applying color. You're not controlling the line. And then as you develop the line, you become more and more detailed. Well, that detail is not there. When you look at the first figure and you look at his coat, the space above him where his head is and his feet are detailed, but the space in the middle, you'll see that it's all look like you took off your glasses. If you wore glasses and everything went foggy, that's how that coat looks like. It's all blurry looking. And it doesn't get controlled as far as the folds are, because folds always point to the area of stress. And if you look at the other clothing of the individuals, you'll know that they become more and more crisp, and it's not there in the first figure, but it does become more progressive as you move further down the length of the mural. So if you're interested and wanted to know how did you get there, it's right there. If you just pay attention and look at what you're looking at and sort of study what you're looking at, you can see how that progression follows.
Very interesting.